was without preference dividend. Now, if there is preference dividend
everywhere,
will there be any impact in degree of operating leverage?
My degree of operating leverage will be the same everywhere. But there will be change with respect to degree of financial leverage.
Yes.
So everyone, please. EBIT divided by EBT. But from EBT, I also have to deduct preference dividend. If I deduct preference dividend, so my EBT is pre-tax, right? But preference dividend is post-tax. So while I'm calculating leverage, I do not want to assess or evaluate anything else except the leverage. So I want to ignore the factor of taxation. Why? Of course I'm paying tax, but I want to ignore because I want to just understand the impact of fixed obligation, not tax. So since we're evaluating everything, if you notice, there is pre-tax, except preference dividend, which is post-tax. So what should I do? I will have to bring preference dividend also pre-tax everywhere. So this preference dividend is anyways post-tax, after tax. So how do I bring it to pre-tax everywhere? What will I do in that case? Preference dividend. So suppose there was pre-tax preference dividend X into 1 minus T will be post-tax preference dividend. So what will be pre-tax dividend? Preference dividend upon 1 minus T. Got my point everyone? So preference dividend, I'll do 1 minus tax rate. And then the combined leverage will be contribution upon EBT minus preference dividend upon 1 minus T. Everyone got that? Why is that so? Because everything else is pre-tax except preference dividend, which goes from your post-tax amount. So I have two choices. Bring everything post-tax, which will not make sense because then tax will perhaps, you know, do what? It will hide out the impact of leverage. So I am not concerned with the tax. I just want to know the impact of leverage. So I want everything pre-tax, but the only amount is preference dividend, which goes from the post-tax amount. So I bring it as pre-tax. So all the amount now we have is pre-tax. So all my fixed obligations. So from EBT, if I minus preference dividend, EBT is pre-tax, but preference dividend is post-tax, right? So I want to minus the pre-tax amount of preference dividend. So I bring it to, you know, pre-tax amount. So whatever this amount is, after that you deduct tax, so you get the actual preference dividend amount. Right everyone? We'll write a note for it, copy that. So suppose preference dividend is 100 rupee and the tax rate was 30. So this 100 is post-tax. This is 70%. So how much is 100%? So 1 minus 3, this is 70%. So I'll have to find the pre-tax amount. Right? So which will be preference dividend upon 1 minus 3, I'll get pre-tax rate. So you have gross into 1 minus 3, you get net, right? So preference dividend is net amount. I want to find the gross amount, which will be net upon 1 minus T. And we'll write a note about it.
Okay, so we do have to write the dynamic formula also. But before that, we have to write the note for this preference dividend. So either you all can write it here or probably in the last 3-4 lines you all can write a note. Like wherever you all can write it. So let us write a note for preference dividend. While calculating the impact of leverage, we consider all the amount pre-tax. However, preference dividend is paid from the post-tax profit. Therefore, we calculate the pre-tax preference dividend. Pre-tax preference dividend as below. You all will write an equation. Pre-tax preference dividend equals to pre-tax preference dividend equals to what exactly? How do we find pre-tax preference dividend? Preference dividend divided by 1 minus T. Preference dividend divided by 1 minus tax rate. So basically, pre-tax is the gross amount of which we deduct tax, we get post-tax. Preference dividend is anyways post-tax, so we bring it to pre-tax. Right? Everyone? Okay. Now, of course, our majority of syllabus is based on static formulas. But we'll be utilizing one very important aspect in leverage, is the dynamic. Everyone? The reason of having dynamic formula is to directly assess the impact of changing something due to something. So have you ever done changing something due to something? Elasticity. What is elasticity, everybody? Change in something due to something, right? What something? Change in quantity, right? Due to change in price. Right? So change in one factor due to change in another factor gives you elasticity, or we say as sensitivity. These are called dynamic aspects. So dynamic tells us change in something due to something. Change in one factor due to another factor. Similarly, in case of operating and financial leverage, we have dynamic formulas which will display us change in one thing because of another. Now we know what is that factor. What is that factor which is going to change operating leverage? Fixed cost. What is that factor which will change financial leverage? Yes. Financing cost, interest. Got my point? That's the reason we also calculate, so that we can directly calculate if we have an operating leverage and if someone tells. So if you have elasticity of suppose 2, and if you have change in prices 10%, you can directly find change in quantity. Getting my point? I repeat, if you have elasticity of 2 and if you have change in prices 10%, you can directly find the change in quantity. Similarly here, if we have that elasticity which is operating leverage or financial leverage, and if we get change in one thing, we can directly find change in another thing. Now this aspect we'll be doing probably after 7-8 sums in leverages, and I'll re-explain that entire thing again. But we'll write the formula out here so that when we have to apply, we can again study what exactly this formula is. So you already write part 2, dynamic. So degree of operating, degree of financial, and degree of combined leverage. Can you tell me what is the reason behind change in operating leverage? Everyone?
Fixed cost.
So we find percentage change in. What will change? EBIT will change, and divided by change in contribution, and that change will be due to fixed cost. So that's right, percentage change in EBIT upon percentage change in contribution. But hold on, contribution which comes after sales less variable cost. So if sales changes by 20%, variable cost will also change by 20%. Everyone? And contribution will also change by same proportion. So we write this formula as changing EBIT upon changing contribution or sales, one and the same thing. So they may give us change in contribution, or they may give us change in copy this. Change in EBIT, percentage change in EBIT upon percentage change in contribution or sales. Okay. In degree of financial leverage, everybody, percentage change in everyone. Percentage change in EBT, everyone, EBT upon percentage change in EBIT. But. Assuming there is no tax, because we don't assess the impact of tax in leverages. So assuming there is no tax, EBT, if there is no tax, then EBT is equal to PAT, right? And if I divide it, that PAT by number of shares, I get EPS, right? So they may give us change in EBT, or instead of that, they may also give us change in PAT or EPS, which will be the same thing because we ignore the impact of tax here. So instead of percentage change in EBT, they may also give us PAT or change in EPS. Right? Copy that. What can you all write? Combined leverage, everyone? Percentage change in EBT, PAT
or EPS, on percentage change in contribution or sales.
Okay, everyone.
Degree of combined leverage, therefore, is nothing but degree of operating leverage into degree of financial leverage.
This is the final formula. Degree of combined leverage is a product of both degree of operating leverage and degree of financial leverage.